Since they're on an 8-game winning streak, this video shows you the truth about the Brooklyn Nets. Kevin Durant's missed half of their games, but Kyrie and the newly acquired Harden have still kept the Nets in the race for the first seed in the East. So stay tuned to see an under-talked-about factor making the Nets scary, and whether or not Brooklyn's the title favorite in 2021. Despite being a powerhouse offensive team, ranked first in points per game and offensive rating, it's no secret Brooklyn isn't elite whatsoever on the other side of the floor, as they're ranked 28th in points allowed, giving up 117 points per contest. So why am I talking about them today? Well, here's why you can't doubt the Nets in 2021 because of their lack of defense. From 2015 to 2019, the Warriors, who won three titles in that time, never ranked top 10 in points allowed. In fact, they were all the way down as the 19th best defensive team in 2015-16, when they broke the Bulls' record for single-season wins. Of course, they went on to blow a 3-1 lead in the finals, but that's a story for another day. The point here is, Golden State's dynasty proved that multiple generationally great offensive weapons on one squad, who are versatile enough to play small ball, can contradict the famous saying, defense wins championships. Brooklyn hasn't lost since February 9th in Detroit, and what's been most shocking about that is that they're playing without KD, as we've only seen the Irving, Harden, and Durant big three intact for a total of 6 games. But considering they're capable of going on incredibly tough Western Conference road trips and coming out 5-0, even without a 2-time Finals MVP in their lineup, that gets you speculating how dominant Brooklyn will be at full strength. Coming up, I'll give you my thoughts on Brooklyn's potential with a healthy Durant. First, we have to talk about the growing and shockingly great chemistry of Uncle Drew, Kyrie Irving, and the beard James Harden. The reason I say the chemistry these two have built up has been shocking is because when Harden demanded a trade from the Rockets and was officially dealt to Brooklyn, a lot of people thought the two egos and ISO-heavy playstyles of James and Kyrie would clash. But that's been the opposite of the case, as according to ESPN's Malika Andrews, James and Kyrie had a brief conversation at practice last week to clarify their roles. This was after the Nets beat the Warriors on February 16th. And Irving told reporters after the game, "We established that maybe 4 days ago. I just looked at him and I said, you're the point guard and I'm going to play shooting guard. That was as simple as that." And since that public declaration from the 7-time All-Star and 2-time All-NBA player, the Nets have added 6 W's and counting to their ongoing win streak. Coincidence? I think not. Because that quote from Kyrie perfectly exemplifies how he's led the Nets on and off the court this year. This Kyrie Irving that we've been seeing in 2021, the guy who's been saucing up defenders, hitting jumpers in traffic, and manufacturing shots from nothing, is reminding me of the 1A option he was in the Cavs championship run back in 2016. But what's proof of the 28-year-old Kyrie Irving being in his athletic prime is the fact that in prior seasons, he was never dunking the ball like this. The hang time and ferocity Irving threw it down with in transition right here seems like a glitch in 2K, but it just shows off the shape this man's in and the free-flowing confidence he's playing with. I don't know about you, but I missed watching this Kyrie over the last few years. The guy seems happier than ever, and a lot of that has to do with one of the greatest playmakers of this generation recently being traded to his team. There's been talk on Twitter recently from former NBA players of James Harden being the best player in the league right now. But throughout his 8 seasons in Houston, the pick and roll and ISO scoring savant, foul drawing fiend, and distance shooting dagger artist James Harden never had one, let alone 2 superstar talents next to him. But I guess sometimes trade demands come to fruition. Now, not only does he have 2 superstars next to him, but 2 generationally great talents. And Harden looks expectedly refreshed on his new team, as he's already broke the Nets franchise record in single-game assists twice, dropping 14 and 16 dimes in 2 different games respectively. Something that's been influencing Harden's perfect fit in the offense is the underrated IQ that both he and Uncle Drew have moving and cutting without the ball in their hands. From all the space on the floor that James and Kyrie always have between one another, to the backdoor cuts they're constantly making, and the way in which they maneuver around off-ball screens, the offensive awareness of Brooklyn's backcourt is overwhelming opponents. When it comes to running sets and picking apart defensive game plans, Harden's gonna handle that, and considering Kyrie's averaging a career high in points per game at 27.4 and field goal percentage at 52.1, Irving playing the majority of his time off the ball next to Harden has made all the sense in the world. Stick around to see the Nets' potential with KD in the lineup and whether or not the Nets are the title favorite, but before that, I have to talk about the Nets' most valuable role player by far, Joe Harris, who's a criminally under-talked about reason for Brooklyn's success. He's getting all the open shots in the world and taking full advantage of it. Harris is leading the league in three-point field goal percentage, shooting 7 threes per game, and knocking down a stellar 50.9% of them. Joe is absolute money from distance, but he's also an exceptional scorer in general, as he's had 8 games of scoring at least 20-plus points on the season, and maybe no one's going to mention him like the three superstars, but Harris is a crucial piece to the puzzle. After he put up 22 points on 6-for-7 shooting on national television in a road game against the Lakers, his response to Reggie Miller here says a lot about his unselfishness.
Right, as Kevin just mentioned, 21 points, 6-of-7 from downtown.
Yeah, I mean, playing with those guys, obviously unbelievable at all three levels. Facilitating, creating shots for guys like myself just makes the game a lot easier, especially when you know when the ball's coming to you. More likely than not, you know, you got space, that's why the ball's coming your way.
Then there's the 24-year-old Bruce Brown, who's been the steal of the 2020 offseason for the Brooklyn Nets. Bruce was taken by the Detroit Pistons with the 42nd pick back in 2018, and it was GM Sean Marks' biggest swindle as he packaged a young asset in Zanon Musa and a 2021 second-round pick for a legit starter and impact player in Brown. He's now playing starter minutes on a championship team, while Musa is playing in the Turkish League. Displaying his scoring, Brown tallied a career-high 29 points, in the Nets' win over the Sacramento Kings recently, which was their 7th straight win. Additionally, without the floor spacing of shooters like Tyler Johnson and Landry Shamet, then Brooklyn's best players wouldn't have enough room to operate. Johnson and Shamet are two guys that have bounced around the league before this year, but they've both been reliable options for Irving and Harden to kick it out to. So having said all of that, is a center rotation revolving around DeAndre Jordan enough for me to declare that the Nets are the title favorites? Well, the former member of the Lob City Clippers may be past his prime, but at 32, DJ's still doing a solid job protecting the rim for Brooklyn. He's averaging a pretty decent 1.5 blocks per game in just 22.5 minutes. Of course, he doesn't have the same hops that he had when he was a Clipper, but he has turned back the clock a few times and looked like the LA version of himself by throwing down some lobs. So it may surprise you, but I actually think DeAndre is capable of holding down the center spot on Brooklyn in a championship run. Jordan can still rotate defensively and defend the paint at a fairly high level, and at this point in his career, he's become underrated. But it's actually the Nets' lethal and potentially all-time great small ball lineup, consisting of KD at the center, that's most intriguing. This unit features the versatile combo forward Jeff Green at the 4, the sharpshooting Joe Harris at the 3, and of course filling out the backcourt, the elite bucket getter Kyrie Irving and the flashy playmaker James Harden. It's going to be a massive struggle to take down the firepower that this Nets team possesses in 4 games out of 7, and taking into account AD's health with the reigning champs in LA, combined with how this Nets team is tearing through the league minus the snake, there's no reason to say that this Nets team isn't the 2021 title favorite. Things could change, but the powerhouse Nets are my early pick to win it all. And I'm not a betting man, but if I found a casual willing to put their money on these Nets getting beat 4 out of 7 times in the playoffs, then I may become one. But am I overhyping the Nets? Let me know down below. Have a great day. You're the best for sticking around. This was D-Flow, and I'll see you next video.